Deontay Wilder is one of the most exciting fighters in the world today. 32 knockouts. He's a bronze medalist in the Olympics, and there's a lot of talk that he's going to fight the WBC heavyweight champion in the world, Bermane Stiverne. Wilder coming off a big victory this weekend at the Home Depot Center, improving his record, Joe, to 32-0 with 32 knockouts. What can you say about that?
I think Deontay Wilder is really a devastating puncher. I kind of nicknamed him the Tommy Hearns of the heavyweight division. You know, he's just, whether they're supposed to be good or, you know, mediocre fighters, he takes care of them all the same. He knocks them out. He's got a great right hand. He's got a good jab that sets it up. He's, you know, I've seen him against one of my guys. Unfortunately, you know, we got stopped in the first against him, but the guy hits very hard. Sometimes it doesn't even look like he's putting everything behind it, but everyone says his hands are really heavy. Now, that being said, against Stiverne, you know, when I saw him fight against Chris Areola, Chris, even with a bad arm going into that fight, was able to land several right hands on Stiverne and, you know, kind of got to him a little bit. And Stiverne was sitting on the ropes for a lot of that. Now, he countered off the ropes.
Very fast, really well. Very quick hands for Stiverne.
But, you know, I don't think Wilder is going to commit, you know, to that close of a game with him, especially early. But my point is, if Chris Areola could get to him with those right hands.
You say that Wilder will do the same?
I just think Wilder will be able, if he lands it, he's going to hurt Stiverne with it. Now, it'll be a great test to see if Stiverne can take the right hand of Wilder. If he can stand up to it, I think he's got a great shot. But I think he's going to get hit with it. And I think that Wilder will probably try to keep him at arm's length for most of the fight. So, you know, Stiverne himself is a little bit of a boxer mover. He's not really a pressure fighter. So, you know, if he stays on the outside, I think Wilder's going to really have a lot of the reach advantage there. Now, he's a little bit untested at this level here. So Stiverne, who's a really good fighter and hits hard in close quarters, you know, it's going to be a big test for him. But I like Wilder's power.
I call it now, 4 rounds.
Who wins?
Fight's going to end in 4 rounds.
And then the knockout?
The guy, whoever
it ended in a knockout in 4 rounds?
I think so.
But you can't call the winner?
You gotta be careful.
I think they both can crack. They both can, you know, they both got a good chance. Wilder and him, I think. Because, you know, Chris was landing some pretty good shots.
He was?
Man, he just,
well, that's my whole point.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if Wilder, you know, can land those punches and
Wilder,
let
me tell you,
can crack.
He's not only does he have a great right hand, he's got a solid left hook, too, Vanez. He's got a solid left hook, and I've seen him in a few fights when I was studying tapes on him. He's got a great liver shot. He's got a great left uppercut. Now, I've seen him get out of control a little bit. But, you know, I think fight after fight,
you learn,
you refine that. And he's probably been working on that for a while. But,
Joe, yeah. If I got in the ring with Wilder, how long does it take him to knock me out?
You wouldn't get in the ring.
Not even 1 second. Like, by the time I got to the ropes, I'm done.
You'd probably faint by the time you got close enough to him where it wouldn't matter.
All right, there you have it. Joe Goossen, Vanez Martirosyan. Vanez gets back in the ring October 4th. Look out for him. We'll have more information, who, where, what, and all that good stuff. You can follow him on Twitter @VanezBoxing. Stay tuned with EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting. Yeah.